happened was, this ticket was filed. Then they said, sorry, we will not treat you as PTI candidates because the Supreme Court judgment is there. So withdraw your tickets. They actually returned the tickets. I refused to take it back. I said, no, I'm not going to take my ticket back. You, in fact, give me a receipt that I filed my ticket. And that is why this receipt was given to me. And yet when they filed these documents with their CMA, they suppressed this ticket to say, I only filed.
Mr. Raja, you used the word 3-4 times. Can we make the point now? The
point is that the record filed by them is not reliable. Now let
me come. Fine. Then is there anything preventing? The matter is being contested in open court. The document is on record. Yes. If any party disagrees, disbelieves with a document, they can file their document.
No, I've shown from this instance that the documents they have filed are
there
not
in your possession. I'm sure everybody makes photocopies. Parties could have brought those on record.
But they're in their possession also. All I'm showing is that documents in their possession.
Can we get on with the case?
Not being filed. Yes, my lord. Now, let me come to my 7 points. I was going to do this at the very end, but I've done it.
Mr. Raja, kisi zamane mein government or constitutional bodies bona fide litigants samjhe jaate
hain. Ji.
Ab to ECP bhi mukadma jeetne aayi hai like an ordinary litigant.
They are acting as if there are adversaries. They should be independent, impartial
instead
arbiters of the election process.
They have come before us to behaving like an ordinary litigant.
Absolutely.
They want to win the case.
Their interest should be, I bow, their interest should be to give effect to the will of the people. I don't see that happening. The suppression of documents in the case they have chosen to highlight. I have not chosen to file my documents. They filed my documents forcing me to file my tickets. Now let me read through my points, hopefully within 10 minutes. Number one, Kawal Shozab's right to file the appeal and be heard. She heads the PTI Women's Wing. She was one of two whose name was included in the list for women's reserved seats filed by PTI. SIC has confirmed that she remains a leading contender in case seats are allowed to SIC. She is directly affected by the outcome of the proceedings before the SC. And I refer to pages 7 and 23 of CMA 5917, in which the list in which her name is included, the women's seats list that PTI filed, is there. And at page 23 is the Sunni Tahat Council certificate recognizing her as a leading contender for a women's seat if they are allowed. So she is not just anybody off the street.
Please, aage badhiye.
Ji, sir.
What's the point in making these statements off the street?
Lord, allow me to.
I mean, even if she's off the street, she's the highest respect.
Lord,
ye baatein na karein.
Unki yaad
thi
that she's not entitled to maintain.
Please, aage badhiye.
Now, a political party can gain a general seat in two ways. Either when one of its ticket holders is declared successful as a result of polling, this would be a directly won seat, or an independent joins it. So general seats can be acquired in two ways. Either way, the party is said to have secured or won a general seat. The sole purpose of the proviso in Article 51(6) is to clarify, 51(6D) I should say, is to clarify that independents joining a party will be treated as seats won by that party. Nowhere does Article 51(6) speak of directly won general seats. That's a very important distinction. Directly won seats are on polling day. Other seats won are when independents join. They're both general seats. Reserved seats are to be allowed on the basis of general seats. Number three, the issue of the grant or otherwise of reserved seats to SIC turns on how the phrases each political party and such political party as used in Article 51(6)(d) and E are interpreted along with the words secured and includes. There is no clear statement that only parties with at least one directly elected seat may be allowed a reserved seat. The interpretation made must advance the basic purpose of the Constitution, which is a representative National Assembly based on facilitation of political parties in the electoral process and the affairs of the House. Granting reserved seats to other parties in a proportion greater than the general seats won would make the National Assembly unrepresentative. Number four, the judgment of the Peshawar High Court is based on its interpretation of the word includes, and I refer to paras 15 to 17 of that judgment in particular. I draw the court's attention to paras 15 to 17 of the Peshawar High Court judgment. It has held that since in interpretation clauses, the word includes does not imply exclusivity. It cannot imply exclusivity in Article 51(6). It excludes political parties that exclusively consist of independents who have joined them. So this is the reasoning that...
आप कहना ही चाहते हैं पीटीआई की होते हुए आप ये कहते हैं कि जो लोग सुनी इत्यादि में गए वो ठीक गए
बिल्कुल ठीक है क्योंकि हमें
आपको नहीं चाहिए
नहीं सर हमें इंडिपेंडेंट जब डिक्लेयर कर दिया उसके बाद वी हैव जॉइंड सुन्नी इत्तेहाद इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द लॉ, वी वर डिक्लेयर्ड इंडिपेंडेंट. उससे पहले जो भी हुआ वो इलेक्शन कमीशन की गलती है, फॉर दैट वी कांट बी फॉल्टेड. सो आई एम मेकिंग अ केस दैट वंस वी वर डिक्लेयर्ड इंडिपेंडेंट वी ड्यूली जॉइंड सुन्नी इत्तेहाद एंड वंस वी जॉइंड सुन्नी इत्तेहाद.
आपका स्टेटमेंट जरा एक दफा फिर आप सोच लें. सपोज अगर हम इस नतीजे पे पहुंचे कि वो गलत गए थे SIC में,
जी
तो आपको नहीं चाहिए?
नहीं सर, देखिए कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हैज टू बी इंटरप्रेटेड.
ऐसा नहीं हो सकता, आप या चाहेंगे या नहीं चाहेंगे.
नो सर, यू विल अप्लाई द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. माय प्रेयर इज नॉट गोइंग टू कंस्ट्रेन योर इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. अगर आप समझेंगे कि इन दी सर्कमस्टेंसेज आई शुड बी अलाउड सीट्स एज PTI, आई विल नॉट रिफ्यूज ऑब्वियसली. बट आई एम सिंपली स्टेटिंग दैट एक्टिंग ऑन हाउ द इलेक्शन कमीशन ट्रीटेड अस, दे डिक्लेयर्ड अस इंडिपेंडेंट, वी देयरफॉर हैड नो ऑप्शन बट टू जॉइन द सुन्नी इत्तेहाद काउंसिल. वी कुड नॉट हैव रीजॉइंड PTI बिकॉज बैरिस्टर गौहर
declaration by the election commission was correct.
In my opinion, not. I challenged it, sir. I challenged it. But that is where it stands. So because we were declared independent, we joined the Sunni Ittehad Council, and on that basis, we are claiming the benefit of Article 51, 6 D and E, where there is no language ousting parties that only have seats on account of independence joining them. There is no language. And the Peshawar High Court, in fact, says it is adopting purposive interpretation. They somehow find the purpose of the Constitution to be to facilitate parties with one directly elected seat. Nothing in the Constitution says that. So in fact, the entire argument regarding purposive versus literal interpretation works in my favor. Where is the language in Article 51-6D that says at least one seat should be won? They're inferring that from the word includes in the Peshawar High Court. And let me read.
सलमान अकरम राजा साहब, आपका ये पॉइंट फैसल सिद्दीकी साहब का केस डिमोलिश नहीं कर रहा है?
नहीं पता सर, आई एम मेकिंग माय पॉइंट. योर लॉर्डशिप्स आर गोइंग टू इंटरप्रेट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड अप्लाई इट. योर लॉर्डशिप्स आर नॉट बाउंड बाय रीडिंग्स, योर लॉर्डशिप्स आर नॉट बाउंड बाय आर्गुमेंट. आई स्टैंड वेयर आई स्टैंड एंड आई से दिस विद ग्रेट कन्विक्शन एंड क्लैरिटी दैट देयर इज नो नीड फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ inference or reading in into Article 51-6G or E. The language is clear. There is no requirement of one directly elected seat. The Peshawar High Court has read that requirement into Article 51-6G. Kindly read paragraphs 15 to 17. The interpretation made, I say, must advance the basic purpose of the Constitution, which is a representative parliament. And any other interpretation which reads this requirement of one directly elected seat results, as we can see today, in an entirely unrepresentative parliament. That cannot be the interpretation. I move on.
Raja sahab, aap ji isi point se, when you talk about representative parliament, it is that fundamental right of the voter.
Yes, my lord.
In
yes.
the context of that fundamental right of the voter, should this court not correct the grave violation of the entire electoral process by the Election Commission by excluding a political party from the election process?
All the facts are now before your lordships, and your lordships can make any order that advances and implements the Constitution. We are only here to assist. Your lordships are not bound by my prayer, they are not bound by my arguments. So anything that your lordships feel is the mandate of the Constitution should be granted. Now I move on, kindly see. The Peshawar High Court, I'm still reading paragraph 4, has called this purposive interpretation by saying that since the word includes in definition clauses does not imply exclusivity, therefore here also in Article 51-6 D, it will not imply exclusivity. Now that's a completely different context. In interpretation clauses or definition clauses, there is often a contest between the word includes and means. We say means this is exhaustive, the definition is exhaustive. Includes means that the definition is not exhaustive. So somehow the Peshawar High Court has taken that distinction to imply that in Article 51-6 D and E, and a party that consists exclusively of independents who have joined it is not permitted. Now, there is nothing in the Constitution to say that. Kindly read paragraphs 15 to 17 of the Peshawar High Court judgment. In addition, it is submitted that the Peshawar High Court has erred in interpreting the word includes as if it only means added to. The word includes is a general umbrella term. If I say this class includes boys and girls, it does not mean that there has to be at least one boy for girls to be allowed into that class. This course includes both boys and girls. It's simply saying that when everything has been taken
without a single person, boy or girl,
yes, anybody can be included.
Baat to suna ji, kisi bache aur bachi ke bagair class hoga?
No, वो ये कह रहे हैं कि आप ज्वाइन कर लेंगे,
इसी को ज्वाइन करेंगे,
ज्वाइन किसको करेंगे? अ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी एग्जिस्ट्स आउटसाइड पार्लियामेंट. वी नो पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज एग्जिस्ट आउटसाइड पार्लियामेंट. सो आई एम सबमिटिंग देयर इज नो लैंग्वेज. योर लॉर्डशिप्स विल हैव टू इंट्रोड्यूस समथिंग टू द लैंग्वेज इन ऑर्डर टू क्रिएट दिस रिस्ट्रिक्शन.